Right, so here we are once again in our Balmora home. It's been a while. It won't be for the guys on YouTube. It'll just be a couple of days if I manage to get this all sorted out correctly. But, oh dear, yeah, it's been about a week since I last played Morrowind. And, oh yes. We have to go to Tel Fyr. Oh boy, yeah, this is the part of the game that usually made me stop playing. Because a lot of the time I don't really dip into magic or anything like that. And then I just have to rely on potions and whatnot, and then I just get too lazy to make the potions, and then I kind of drift away, lose interest. But I'm going to power through it, being a spellcaster, in fact the Archmage of the Mages Guild. I should be able to get some... Oh, yeah, that's training, that's not spell making, or spells. I should just make a spell, or buy a spell that I need. This is the reason why I tend to stay away from Telvanni areas. Is their towers. There's quite a few of the towers require some kind of ability to go up.
Warm greetings, Outlander. Care to peruse my spell?
And there we go. Levitate. That's what we needed. Right, now, let's just jump right into it. Sadrith Mora, please.
With pleasure. Please, go ahead. I'm all ears.
Well, I'm just stopping here for a moment. Right. If it wasn't for this Mage's Guild, I would have had to take the long and angrier route to Archmage. But because I did the quests here, I was able to get the reputation to bypass that aspect of climbing the ladder. Always get turned around in Wolverine Hall. Yeah. But anyway, that's... So this is where we need to be going. Over yonder. Right. Now, probably a good idea for me to get Amphibian ready. There we go. Do our Argonian thing. Now on the plus side, this trains up our athletics. Not that we need it so much now. I mean, I'm already moving at a fairly swift pace, and, well, by Morrowind's standards at least. And I'm able to outrun most hazards. Argonians are reptilians. Hello, children of radiation. And yes, they are. But the well. Hello. Ow. That reptile's with good lung capacity. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Oh, I'm just gonna leave him to it. I hate the hitboxes on the slaughterfish. Once you knock them out, they just start spazzing out and then I can't see where it is I'm supposed to be striking. I mean, at least with humanoid characters, you know, you can, once they fall over, you just spank them, quite literally. hence the name, Spanks-the-Wayward. But then again, I've mentioned that several times now. Here we go again. Stop it. Stop it. Well, that one I actually managed to kill. I guess when it comes to secret governments, amphibians are even more powerful and spooky than reptiles, or the reptilians. I mean, yeah. If a certain Mr. Jones is anything to go by. Oh, I've overshot Tel Fyr. Yeah, I've overshot Tel Fyr. Oh no. Sorry, what are you doing? You need to be stronger than this, Sorrow. Right, well, we've made it to, well, the island of Tel Fyr. Now I just need to get into Tel Fyr. Whee! Slide down the hill. Is there a boatman here that I could have... No, there's not. Oh, yes, there is. Okay, so where could I have hopped on a boat from? Whoops. Oh, no, it's not a travel boat. Oh, okay, fair enough. We're okay. I didn't make a fool of myself. Well, not any more than usual. Here we go. Well then, who was it I was supposed to speak to again? Divayth. Have you come to plunder the dungeon? Or have you got Corprus disease, or did you come to see Divayth? I'm Divayth. I'm the wife of Divayth Fyr. One of them. Sort of. He's above in his study. I hope you can fly. You can't get up there unless you can fly. Or have potions, sorry. Wife? Well, yes, well, not wife in the married sense, but, you know, paramour, consort, something like that. It's a bit awkward, really, because, well, he has made us too, so... Though we aren't really his daughters or anything, it's like we're his daughters. Because he made us. You see? Oh dear. Well, that took a rather awkward turn. Ah. Too much information.
I will listen, Outlander.
It's
quickly, Outlander.
Sorrow.
We haven't much time.
It's, yeah, it's definitely much a case of, I've cloned myself so neither of us can be virgins.
I will listen, Outlander.
Where am I going? Where am I going? This is why I hate these blue. These towers.
I haven't much time.
Wretched towers.
Quickly out.
What? It... Oh, dear. Do I have to go down before I go up? Yeah. In his study... Sure he won't mind being disturbed. We've got, you know, we get a few visitors here. You can levitate, can't you? Study is on an upper level, accessible by the central flywell. Afraid we aren't set up to accommodate barbarians or peasants. You understand? Go up the ramps to the Hall of Fear, then walk around, looking up until you see the shaft above you. Then levitate, up the shaft, then look for Lord Fear in his study. Okay. Wait, what's, yeah, not going in there. I've got absolutely no interest in, plundering the dungeon. Oh, wow. Really? Actually, that's a good
Quickly,
point.
Outlander, I haven't much time.
I mean, I didn't notice the ceiling because of the lack of shadows, and I've just noticed that since my last go at the game, I forgot to put the shadows back on, or the character shadows at least. Yeah. It doesn't really help with the interiors still, but... I'm glad I noticed it now. Ah, levitate time. Whee! That looks like someone we need to know. Yeah, I don't want to talk to any more people than I want to. It's just getting weirder and weirder.
Quickly, Outlander. I haven't much time.
Okay, settle down. Say, that's an interesting Dwemer piece you have there. What can you tell me about it? Well, I was told to give this as a gift. So, yeah, a gift for me? How thoughtful and shrewd. I suppose you know I'm a collector, and that such a gift is bound to please me. I congratulate you on your diplomatic skills. So, why have you tried to butter me up and come to consult the great Divayth Fyr? You have the divine disease? Want to plunder the dungeon or leer at my daughters? Ah, dear. I had forgotten about this weird dynamic. As I say, I don't usually get very far in the main quest when I play this game. Right, yes, the divine disease. Now, the magical principles of the Corprus disease are elusive and miraculous. Far more subtle and powerful than any conventional sorcery or enchantment. persuaded that it is in some manner the curse or blessing of a god. Perhaps both a curse and a blessing. The victim, of course, cannot appreciate the marvellous nature of Corprus. It saps the mind and destroys the body. But to a wizard, it is a profound and glorious mystery. A riddle worth a long lifetime of study. Yeah. Right. How interesting. Did you know that Corprus makes you immune to disease? Have you ever heard of the prophecies of the Nerevarine? Actually, I'd say that the Nerevarine will be immune to a disease. I've always thought, maybe I have the Nerevarine down in my Corprusarium. And I didn't even know it. The Nerevarine is a fat, disgusting Corprus monster. And mad as a marsh rat. Wouldn't that be funny? He's probably be interested in all this, and is probably mad enough that he wouldn't bother with anyone else. Let's tell him what's going on. That's a fascinating story you tell. So you might be the Nerevarine. Means nothing, of course. Corprus victims of all sorts of delusions, but let me think. I've got a potion. In theory. It should cure Corprus. It doesn't work, though. It'll probably kill you. Killed all my test subjects. But you've got nothing to lose. Before I give it to you, I want you to look around below in the Corprusarium. Know what's in store for you if you don't take the potion. And while you're there, I want you to pick up a pair of boots from a victim. He calls himself Yagrum Bagarn. My oldest patient, handy fellow, fixes things for me. Bring the boots back, and then you can have the potion. Right. The Corprusarium. I collect victims of the divine disease in my Corprusarium. In the caverns beneath my tower. Poor devils. Wretched existence. Constant pain. Ferocious appetites and passions. No reason at all. Mad as marsh rats. But marvellous, too, in their way. They're completely immune to disease. Live forever, barring accidents. Ancient wizards need projects to keep them occupied, and the Corprusarium is mine. Okay. Well, I have a feeling the plunder the dungeon conversation topic is a trap. There are a number of trap conversation pieces in Daggerfall and Morrowind, so I'm always wary. Let's just pop down a new save here. Who knows what might go wrong soon. So with that done, let's have a quick poke around. No, nothing of interest here. That's a nice high skill level cupboard you've got there. Mind if I train my security skill a little? It's no trap. You're probably right, but I'm still not going to risk it. I'd rather not get on Divayth's bad side, and I know there are ways you can do that. I've managed to get rid of the trap and picked the lock here. What's in here? Curse of the Savior's Hide. Resist Magicka. But it's light armor, so it's practically useless for us. Oh well. We tried. Ow. Well, I didn't think it would be that bad.
Go ahead.
Now, we gotta be quite careful. I think. Isn't that where we need to be going? Oh, dear. Okay, well. Did I need to speak to Divayth to get access to it? I mean, I could always just pick the lock, but I don't know, it seems even ruder, especially after already breaking into... Ah, what the heck, let's just... I've done it once, I might as well do it again. The mercurial mind of Mookie. Yeah, got it on the last try at least. Hmm. This is not where I was expecting...
Speak quickly, Outlander, or go away.
Okay. That's not where I was expecting to end up. Did I take a wrong turn? No. Dear, oh dear. I keep having this problem. Well, whatever. Oop, oop, oop. Did I miss anything up above?
Speak quickly, Outlander, or go away.
Nothing up there, either. I get so confused in these places.
It's all good.
I do want to know what on earth these are. I mean, they look like soul gems, but they're a bit on the large side. Oh. Blah, 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 blah. There's a strong box in his room. That's true. When you live for thousands of years, you need a hobby, something you love. What sparks your interest? I collect treasures and invite thieves to steal them. I'm a collector and a sportsman. I collect enchanted items and ancient artifacts. Quite a few Dwemer pieces. As a sportsman, I love letting thieves try to steal my well-guarded treasures. Only a few rules. Don't hurt the inmates. Two, don't hurt any my daughters. My warden and guards can look out for themselves. Warden? Mr. Kai, the Argonian, is my warden of the Corprusarium. What a fighter. Tough as nails, self-taught. Works out with my daughters, who know slouches at the martial arts themselves. Mr. Kai was one of the last of my slaves, Freedom, and he wouldn't leave. Kept him on as a hireling, made him my partner. Excellent fellow, fine companion. Not an intellectual, you understand, but company for me and my daughters. Right, okay, so... there's a warden around somewhere. Hmm. Oh god, I just noticed this corpus meat is pulsing. You. Yes, there is a strong box in his room, and I don't particularly want to anger him.
Where's that slave? Here not long ago.
I may try to raid it on the way out of here, but... Yeah. Okay, so it's not up here. I guess maybe it's outside somewhere? Well, if he notices me, he's going to care. Oh dear, these... I mean, this isn't even a particularly difficult area to navigate, really. It's just that all the walls and the ceilings and floors blend together to me. I mean, I'm not colorblind, but I may as well be when I'm in these places. To the Corprusarium. Really? Okay, I did manage to get turned around a bit. Right. Hello. I'm Fyrs the Guy, Warden of the Corprusarium. I'm here to warn you, do not harm the inmates. If you come to plunder the dungeon, you must endure their attacks. And take your chances with me, their warden and protector. Well, not necessarily here to plunder, but if I get the chance. It seems like I've been given the, opportunity to. Right. Off we go. Sneaky time. The wiki says it's okay. Okay, well, that's unusual, but if the wiki says, who am I to say no? Although the wiki has been known to be wrong sometimes. Nope. Oh yeah. Excellent. But that goes down. Rat. Ooh. What's over here? Very well. Wait, into the corpus. Ooh, and there's a chest. Interesting. Don't mind if I do. E to Tel Fyr number 678. Okay. A dwelling goblet. And I've just noticed my encumbrance. There's probably a reason for it. Probably should have done a bit of spring cleaning before going on this epic quest onto the other side of Vardenfell. Yeah. Well, I'm pretty sure I need to get deeper into this this part of the Corprusarium. Not so keen on this rather horrid greeny yellow haze that's in this cave. It's like they've taken a few too many cues from Nurgle. Ooh, another chest. Hidden away back here. Of course, it's another trapped level 100 vox. Get rid of the trap. Break the lock. Key to Tel Fyr number 1092. And even more Dwemer goblets. You know what? I don't really need them. I have lots of money already. I'm just here for the skills at this point. Oh, there was a starting key on his table. Oh, okay. Yeah, I completely missed that. But then again, I wasn't particularly looking for it. Some poor fellow didn't make it very far. Well, I guess he made it into the bowels of this wretched place, but... yeah, didn't make it much further than that. Ooh. Ah, I get you. So it's like a sequence. And I'm just coming along, breaking that sequence. What a shame.